let's hit save. We don't want to lose our precious progress. Delete this. Okay. Let's leave that there. Let's open the door again. And now we're going to start making the fun part of it. Okay, there's multiple ways that we can open the door smoothly enough for it to be visually appealing. Door opening, visually appealing, what the fuck? Anyways. So we can either use float interpolation, or we can use a timeline, but that's specific to blueprints. That's gonna be a tough choice, but let's do it on the, let's use interpolation, because just in case you want to port this over to C++, you can't use timelines on C++. And they're exclusive to Blueprint, so we're going to be using interpolation. Okay. So we got the door state. Let's add tick. Now, custom event. Again, like I repeat myself, you can use functions to keep, to have it more organized, but I'd rather, for the tutorial's sake, I just put everything on the screen. So, when we press E, it's gonna detect the door state, and it's gonna do the logic according to which door state it is in. Okay, so I think we're gonna be using this on switch. Let's just put it there quickly. Switch. Okay. Ready. We're gonna call this manage door. I'm building this with you guys out of my head, like I always do. So it's a learning experience for both of us. Okay, manage the door. So when we press E, we want to manage door. So if the door is closed, we want to partially open it. And if the door is partially open, we want to open it completely. And if it's open, we want to close it. That's a pretty simple loop. So, how are we gonna tackle that? We're gonna be using interpolation, so we need a gate here. Let me think this over a little bit. Okay, we're gonna add a bool. Is interacting with door. And this is gonna be set. To true when we touch the door, which then it's gonna open this branch, and we're gonna call manage door. This should last, I think, 2 seconds. Yeah, that's the best way. So let's compile. Let's go back to our character. So BP door set is door, yeah, interacting. So we're gonna set this to true, or we can, no, way better. Let's do a custom event. Okay, is interacting with door. Okay, interacting with door. So we set this to true, which then is gonna start this logic here. So, interacting with door. Set to true, then we're gonna start a timer. Set timer by event. Simple. And we're gonna set it to 2 seconds. Because that's the amount of time it takes for the sounds that I have specifically for this tutorial to end. They take 2 seconds to play the entire sound. So we want to sync it completely. Okay, so after the time is up, okay, so after the time is done, the timer, we're gonna stop interacting with door. And we're gonna reset back to false. So we got a good loop here. Let's compile. Delete that. Interacting with door. So we basically did everything we had to do on our character. Right here. The door is gonna take care of the rest. Okay, so we got the interaction. Now we need to do the actual logic for the door management. Okay. So let's put... Why do I keep moving everything around? Okay. So if the door is closed, we want to partially open it. Perfectly. So we need to interpolate. We should create a custom event just to interpolate, since we're gonna be copy pasting it over and over. Rotate door. Okay. Here we, it should take a float, which should be the jaw that we want to rotate to. So rotation to set. Quickly, let's see the actual rotations just to get the numbers right. So right now our jaw is 0. If we open a little bit, we want to partially open, I think, 15. 15 should do it. So 15 for partially open. Okay. Yep. 15 partially open, 90 open, 0 closed. Those are my rotation values. Okay, we got the rotations value set. Perfect. Whoa. Buddy, how did you open like that? Okay, rotation set. F interp. Meh. F interp. He's in, he's out. We're just gonna do interp 2, most simple way. Okay, so our current rotation is door mesh get rotation, get the relative rotation, break rotator, and we're gonna plug the jaw in. So it's gonna take our current rotation, the target is gonna be the rotation to set, delta time we're gonna use, I think, let's see, get world delta seconds, there we go, for our delta we're gonna plug that in, and interpolation speed we're gonna be juggling that value too, because like I said before, the sounds for the doors are 2 seconds, so we want to move the door specifically to our sound. So we're gonna just put a generic value of 5, and then we're gonna adjust depending to the door sounds. You can do this depending on your door sounds, but I'm gonna do it depending on my fucking door sounds. Okay. Okay, so return value, perfect. Now we want to set rotation, set relative rotation, make rotator, plug this in, and we're gonna plug the jaw, and we're gonna leave those at 0 because I think they're always gonna be a 0. Yes. Are you closed door? No. Ah! Close. Just zero it out. Why didn't I think about that? Okay. So, let's see if this works. So, if it's closed, rotate door. We are going to partially open it, 15. If it's partially open, we are going to open it completely. This is just gonna work for one side. We're gonna do the math later on. We're just prototyping to see if it actually opens the door. And if it's open, we want to close the door, so zero. Alrighty, let's see if that worked. So I go to the door, press E, partially open. Press E again, fully open, and then close. And if I spam the button, it always does the same thing. So at least we're done for that. Now, here's the code. Let's go over it quickly. Okay, so interacting with door, we set that to true in 1 second. We start this to set that back to false, and then here we set our door state to the new state. Now we want to integrate the math to detect if we are in front or behind the door, and we're gonna be doing that right now.